Tom, just thought of Dylan Draper and done something that no one's done in 15 fights, and you stopped him.
Yeah, quite comfortably as well. I thought like the ref maybe stopped it a little bit early, but he was, he's taking big shots.
Yeah. You
know, so I think, to be honest, if he never stopped it, I probably would have knocked him out.
Yeah,
everything was landing clean as well. Well, the right hand.
I never got a chance to see any of it, mate. I was in here doing an interview, come out, and then it's something that wasn't expected. Like I said, the kid's never been stopped in 15 fights prior to this, and it seems to be.
Yeah, because everyone said that, but I only watched like a round of him, didn't we? Me and Dan watched like a round of that, because that's all you're really getting out of him. But I said I reckon I'd stop him because he comes out clean and he gives you an opportunity to land a big shot. I've seen people land, but. I don't know whether people have just kept it on him as much, but I knew straight away, as soon as like the first 10 seconds, like as soon as it started landing right hands, I knew.
From a guy who'd come into this game as everyone said you had a fantastic amateur style and weren't too sure whether you were going to fit into this pro game, it seems like you're proving everyone wrong and fitting into it perfectly, because that's your second stoppage against two kids who both don't normally get stopped.
Well, yeah, like it's just the work I'm doing with Dan, Tam, all the lads, Macha, Kev, like all it's just like I'm adjusting and just working. We've got a little style that's working and I'm getting stronger all the time and I'm starting to plant my feet, and obviously I must be punching a bit harder as well, because
I noticed that when I came down and I watched you and Nathan Bennett, who's fighting on the show tonight, spar, and you were both sitting down on your shots a lot more, which I think because you both fought at the same amateur club,
didn't
you?
Yeah, we both boxed at the same amateur club. I'm actually missing him now. We both boxed at the Kirkdale for years, just fought loads of rounds, but we had different styles, I'd say. We're both quite elusive as well, similar styles, but he'd stand and hold his feet a little bit more, but I'm doing it now, and obviously I'm reaping the rewards of being with the lads in the gym and adjusting my style and starting to show now.
What does that take you to? 6-0 now?
6-0, yeah. It should have been a fair 6-0, but it doesn't matter now, does it? Listen, it was over winning. And I thought it would be, to be honest. So when Steve said yes to you, it's a little bit gutter, but I didn't think it'd go 6 anyway, but here we go.
So when's next then? Because
6-0.
Is this going to be like a post-season for you?
Hopefully as soon as possible.
Big shows.
Summer, somewhere. I want to start big fights. Yeah, Steve would say he want to start matching us, so matching all his prospects, of course. Yeah, I've been saying for ages, I want to fight good kids, I want to move on. If opportunities will come, I'll take them. I'm looking forward to them, ready
looks
to
like
go.
You're going to be ready for them as well, mate, so
yeah,
well done, Tom.
6-0. Cheers, Lee. Yeah, cheers.
Bye.
Nice one.